1 times 186 is equal to 186. And we can also say 2 times 93 and 3 times 62. And lastly, we can also have 6 times 31. And if we sum them up, we will get 384. And we are done. And this is not the same as what we did earlier. Because what we did earlier was that we were given the number 186. And then we find the sum of the number's divisors. And we saw that it was 384. But right now, we don't even know what number we are going to have. And I don't even know how many of them we are going to have. And the sum of the divisors of that number, or those numbers, we wanted to get 186. So how can we make this work, right? And as you can see, for competition math, you really, really have to think hard. So I'm going to show you guys my approach for this. Assuming I don't know the shortcut to find out the sum of the divisors of a number, then this is what I will do. I'm just going to begin by using a small example, and let's make some observations. So perhaps I'll write this as a little observation right here. Suppose I have a number 40, then I would like to know the sum of its divisor. Then in that case, I will just say, okay, the sum of the divisors of the number 40. Well, we know 1 will work and 2 will work, so I will have to add 2, and then I know 4 will work, and then 5 will work, and then 8 times 5, and then 10, and 20, and then lastly we have 40. Okay, so that will give me the sum of all the divisors, but I'm not just going to add them up like this. I want to look for a much better way to do this. Well, if you look at 40, we can prime factor it, and that will give us 2 to the third power times 5 to the first power. And the truth is, all these numbers can be written in the form of 2 to some power times 5 to some power. For example, for the 1, we can write that as 2 to the 0 times 5 to the 0. Now that's equal to 1, of course. Then for the 2, we can write it as 2 to the 1 times 5 to the 0. And let's just continue. 2 to the 2 times 5 to the 0, and then 2 to the 0 times 5 to the 1st, and then let's just go ahead and add 2 to the 3rd times 5 to the 0, and then for 10, 2 to the 1st times 5 to the 1st, and then 2 to the 2 times 5 to the 1st, and lastly 2 to the 3rd times 5 to the 1. Notice all the powers for 2 has to be in between of 0 to 3. And then because right here is 5 to the 1st, then either you get 0 or 1 for the 5. Alright, that's pretty good. But what's even better is that we can look at this expression and then factor it. Check this out. Right here, I noticed that this and that, they all have factors of 5 to the 0. I know it's just 1, but let's do this, right? I'm going to factor out 5 to the 0, I'll put it at the end. So we get 2 to the 0 plus 2 to the 1st plus 2 to the 2nd, and then 2 to the 3rd. And we multiply that by 5 to the 0. And for the rest, in fact, they all have 5 to the 1st. So let's go ahead and do the same thing. So we are going to get 2 to the 0 plus 2 to the 1, 2 to the 2, and then 2 to the 3rd, and multiply by 5 to the 1st. In fact, you see that this and that can be factored again. So let's go ahead. 2 to the 0 plus 2 to the 1 plus 2 to the 2 plus 2 to the 3rd, and then this and that will just write it as 5 to the 0 plus 5 to the 1st. Very nice. And I chose 40 because it's not a hard number to work out, right? And it's not like easy number that doesn't give me too much insight. And this right here, you see, if we have the prime 2 to the power 3, then we start with star prime 2 and then to the 0, and we add 2 to the 1st and so on, so on, so on, up to 2 to the 3rd. Same thing for the 1, 5 to the 0 plus 5 to the 1st. So what this tells us is that if we have a number n, let's just first write it as the product of prime, and we can always do this, and this is called the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. I'm just going to write down P1 for the first prime. To some power, let me use alpha 1 times the second prime, P2, and another power, alpha 2, and so on, so on, so on. I don't know how many primes that we are going to get. I'm just going to say PK. It has to be a finite amount. And then this right here is some power, let's say alpha K. Based on this, then I will tell you the sum of the divisors of the number n is going to be equal to, start with P1, we raise that to a zero's power, and then we add P1, same prime, to the first power, and so on, so on, so on, up to P1 to that power. And then we just multiply, so I will multiply that by P2, 0 plus dot 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 up to P2, alpha 2, and so on, so on, so on. Lastly, I will still have to do PK to the 0 plus PK to the first, and so on, so on, so on, up to PK to the alpha K. So this right here will be the quick way to find the sum of the divisors of a number. But anyway, okay, here is the idea. I want the sum of the divisors of a number to be 186. And the formula tells us that it's a product of this kind of expressions. So I'm just going to prime factor 186. Actually, just factor, not necessarily prime factor. Yeah? So now, what does this tell us? Well, remember, let's say I'm just going to use this for example first, right? This 3, hopefully, it's like this. This number is just 1, so it's 1 plus some prime that I don't know yet. And this number has to be prime. And then for the 62, I will have to do 1 to some power plus, you know, prime to the first power, and so on, so on, so on. Can we achieve this? Entering a prime here and then maybe a different prime right here. And again, right here, maybe we have more, but that's why I put on the dot, dot, dot. Can we achieve this? Yes. In fact, I can put down 2. 2 is a prime. 1 plus 2 is a prime right here. And then can we achieve 1 plus something that gives us 62? In fact, 61 is the prime. So 61 works. It works wonder, and then we don't need a dot dot dot. In fact, that's it. Alright, so the box that I put down right here, they have to be prime because of this thing right here. Okay, so what does this tell me about the number n? Remember, this 2 right here is like the P1, and then this right here is to the first power, right? So that tells us that we will just have P1 to the first power. So for this, I will tell you the numbers that we need is n equals 2 to the first power, and then we multiply that by, this is my P2, and then that power, which is 61 to the first power. Work this out, we get 122. So this right here is achievable, done. Now we just have to think about the other cases. Can we achieve this? Meaning 1 plus something, and this thing has to be a prime. No, so don't even think about it, because 1 is not prime, so that's not possible. And you might be wondering, how about the first one? Technically, I shouldn't be looking at 1 because that doesn't really do anything. That doesn't break down, right? So for this one, it's trickier. Can you think about 1 plus something to the first power, and this has to be a prime, plus the same prime to the second power, and in fact, I don't even know how many powers that we will have to have. So I don't even know. Can you think about it? The way that I did it is, I just kind of test it out real quick. You can try with 5, then you'll see that 5 wouldn't work. 5 to the third power is 125 already, 5 doesn't work. And of course, that means we will have up to the third power. How about to the fourth power? For the fourth power, you can try with 3, doesn't work, all right? And so on, so on, so on. if you try to the up to the second power, you can try up to 11, 13, 13 wouldn't work. So yeah, in fact, I do not know if we can have a fast way to look at number and write it as the sum of p to some power. I actually don't know if I can have a fast way to do it, but it's not so bad. This right here, I'll just tell you, it's not achievable, right? Yeah, just test it out, right? I'm not going to write down all the possibilities. Now, how about this right here, 6 times 31. This is actually possible. Let me show you. Right here, again, let's do the same thing. 1 plus a prime. And in fact, you can enter the 5 right here already. So that works out wonderfully. And then 1 plus something to the first, plus something to the second, plus something to the third, plus something to the fourth. Is this achievable? Yes, you can just enter 2. That will give us 31. You can go ahead and try it. In fact, this is 2 to the 0, of course. So this right here, 2 to the 0. So this right here will tell us that n could also be, this is 5 to the first power times, just look at the last one, which is 2 to the 4th power, and that's 5, and that's 80. Altogether is 80. 5 times 16, so that's 80. And lastly, what do we do? Well, if you look at this, this is 1 plus 1 doesn't work already, but like this right here is like 1 plus 2, but this right here is that. No, doesn't work. So this right here is also, no. So that being said, the only two numbers that will make this work, in the sense that these are the only two numbers that have the sum of their divisors being equal to 186. So the answer will just be, I'll just write it down right here. The answer for this, I'll just put this down. This plus that to 102. And then we are done.